the next few videos, we're going to work with C#, building web applications, and focusing in on partial page updates. So here's an overview of what we're going to learn in the next few videos. First of all, we're going to work with simple JavaScript and HTML. We'll work with this because it'll avoid having to include anything with C# or Razor syntax. So AJAX and the partial page updates is really a JavaScript technology. We'll then go on to ASP.NET and we'll make a simple page example. And so we'll show you this in the context of a C# application. And then we're going to work with an image gallery. And so this will enhance a previous project that we made called the Products app. And I think we saw in a previous tutorial that we had a very large page with like 1,000 different products shown on one sheet. And the page load was very slow. So we're going to demonstrate the benefits here of a partial page update. And then we're finally going to work with the Buttons application, which is also a previous tutorial that we did in C#. And this is a game. So we're going to show only the updates of a partial piece of the board because, once again, we're trying to improve the browser experience and make the user happier with a more responsive application. And so that's the whole point of a partial page update. So that's what we're going with there. So the technology that we're working with is called AJAX. AJAX is an acronym that stands for Asynchronous JavaScript and XML. And so it's a technique that allows you to only refresh the piece of the page that needs to be displayed. So for instance, you've got one article that needs to be updated. Well, let's only update that one piece instead of force the entire browser to refresh. So the nice thing about AJAX is it allows the communications with the web server to be done in the background. So we say, give me a piece of the page, we do a fetch, and it will automatically partially update that browser. So here's what some code looks like. This is JavaScript using the jQuery library. And you can see in the red rectangle that we have an AJAX request. So it tells us several things. First of all, the type of the data, which is JSON, the URL, such as get songs, and then the success function is what happens after the request has been met. And so then we can either update a piece of the page or put a console message as we see it here. But the idea is that your JavaScript code will work in the background and refresh only a portion of your page. So AJAX is kind of a strange name because it includes XML in the title, X, and we don't use XML very often. So AJAX, the name stuck because AJAX just somehow doesn't sound as good. So this is what XML data looks like. You can see that if we wanted to define a book, we would put these tags in. It looks like HTML code. It's XML markup language. And JSON data would have the same exact information, except it's just a different format. And so in the past few decades, I guess, XML has become less popular and JSON is pretty much everywhere. And so JSON, even though we use it all the time, doesn't get into the name of AJAX. What language is AJAX? Well, it's not really a language at all. It's a technology, it's a technique, and it is used by many different languages. jQuery is a library that is, or was, super popular, still used widely, but you can see from the Google Trends search for the term that it peaked in the mid 2010-12 area? And it's been on a steady decline ever since. And so it's not quite as what it used to be. So more recently, the main reason for jQuery being popular has been deprecated. So you can pretty much do everything in standard JavaScript now that jQuery was designed for. So for example, this is a really good example. The fetch command is now standard code supported in almost every browser. And so fetch does exactly what the AJAX request did, or still does, in JavaScript jQuery. So we don't need jQuery quite so much anymore. So jQuery, though, had a huge impact on the success of JavaScript. And it was pretty much a standardization that would make everything in all these different web browsers work well. So a lot of people don't like it anymore just because it's just an extra add-on that doesn't seem to be needed. It's kind of redundant. But it did serve its purpose. Nowadays, most people would want to do their web browsing or web development front-end work in more of the modern things, such as React or Vue or Angular. And jQuery is not needed as much as it used to be. So in the mid 2010 area, 2005, browsers were not standardized, and Internet Explorer was the worst of them as far as having non-standard JavaScript. And so jQuery provided a overlay which gave a programmer the ability to code one set of instructions and it would work on all browsers. And so that really served a nice purpose. But pretty much today everybody's standardized, and so standard JavaScript does almost everything you need that you would do in jQuery. However, jQuery is not dead, and especially in the context of what we're teaching here, I'm in the middle of a class on C# and ASP.NET, which is Microsoft's framework for building web applications, and it still relies on Bootstrap. So Bootstrap, in turn, relies on jQuery. And so even though Bootstrap 5 is out, and it's the newest version as the moment that I'm making this video, jQuery is still going to be found in thousands, maybe millions of web applications that you'll be encountering in your career. So it's not dead, and it's still very useful for simple applications. It's still a very nice technology. So now let's get started on these four examples that are ahead of us. We're going to make a simple JavaScript and HTML page using AJAX. Then we're going to get into some of the .NET tools with C#. And so that's what's coming up.